When we score?
182?
Huh?
182? As a team? We won.
Y'all won?
Yes.
All right. Is that one of y'all's better scores?
Yes, it was like our second best score of the year.
I guess I may have to come again.
Yes. Of course.
Well, good.
If we're in the playoffs, we're in the playoffs. It could be a possibility for a shootout.
When does Fleming and Buholtz play? Do you know?
Buholtz plays Gainesville this week. And here's the deal: if Gainesville loses to them, and Bartram beats them.
But Gainesville's on a district game, so they don't really mean anything.
Well, Gainesville beats them, I'm sorry. But it all, schedule and record is determined for the shootout.
Oh,
I think there could be a shootout.
Okay.
We think even if we beat Belton, there's going to end up being some type of shootout.
Yes. Yeah. We need, well, Bartram's already beat Fleming.
Bartram beat Fleming.
We need Buholtz to beat. So now we need Fleming to beat Buholtz and Bartram to beat Buholtz and us to beat Bartram.
And then we finish 3-1, they finish 3-1, we get the head-to-head, we're district champ. That's best case scenario.
That's why I don't
want
to play this game first, because we're playing good right now.
Yeah.
And you want to keep that going.
Yeah.
You know, you don't want to sit out for basically 2 weeks.
Yeah.
I mean, then you lose your mojo, you know?
And, you know, the deal is if something happens, if we don't end up playing the game this week, which I don't want to say this is a fact, I don't really want to say the game, if something happens and we don't, and if we don't end up making the playoffs, I think we'll probably get them in like a bowl game, classic type thing, which I'll finish the year for the seniors. I think that'd be the only way that kids would, you know, get excited about doing something not making the playoffs. I'm going to talk to Tom about it because I'm pretty sure they're going to make the playoffs.
They are, aren't
they? I am. They're not going to. They're going to get beat by Baker next week. Clemson had like 4 turnovers and so did
Louisville.
Somebody I kind of thought would do a good job.
Yeah, what did he say?
He said he had no idea what happened. He asked me if I'd heard anything. I was like, Coach, you just told me.
Randolph went into his room and he was doing like a word start.
losing right now.
No, we don't.
That's the good thing about it.
But it was like, oh my God.
Well, I've never known him in a teaching setting, so that's not why. I didn't know that.
And it's so bad because I like the guy, he's a nice guy, but I mean, and a couple other teachers were like,
that at least is relieving to me. I thought he did something drastically immoral.
No, no, no. It was just, again.
Never give them that benefit of the doubt. I did have a kid break his thumb the other day in a JV walkthrough, and three ways. A, the defensive lineman should never even approach him. B, the coach should have established the tempo immediately, which is normally what's happening. And C, when the kid's running at you, don't throw the ball. And is it like it's a three-way deal, and you know the guy's right in front of him, and he's like not to kill him, just he runs and stops, and the kid throws the ball over the top of him and breaks his arm, and you know immediately starts to see if you have that. He kind of owned it, you know, like, look, that's on me. I should have made sure that the D-line was not in a regular rush or anything.
Some kind of
refer you to the doctor, you go get your x-ray, and you know, you'll find out what happened. Well, I guess their whole problem was not necessarily that it happened, which that was my problem. Their problem was that when it happened, Justin said, "Come on, man, tough it out." And no one has any idea what the injury is, you know? And I know what Justin's the tough West Sider, like, push through the pain, see what you can do. And once he gets going, he was like, "All right, go away." Well, Zane was also the kid that, "Oh, this hurts, I can't do it."
Crying wolf.
And I think that was a combination of it. And you know, they weren't pleased that he told him to tough through it. And they weren't pleased that, you know, that when he talked about it, when he talked about it later, he kind of underplayed the situation when he was talking to Xander. No one knows what said about that. It's not a big deal.
Yeah, it is what it is. But yeah, all that other stuff. Amazing, some winning quiets everything down.
Yeah.
Well, it's all the big now.
His first year with us, he quit his sophomore. No one, I've been on football as coaching training for 20 years. No one has ever quit and later down the line says that was a good decision. That decision benefited me in any way.
Need that extra baggage anyway. You gave him a chance.
Yeah.
And
you know, Denali, that kid that right
now
is a puppy.
Yeah.
He's a freshman. He's pretty good. You know, we'll start focusing on him and some practice reps, get him ready to be a good backup and get some starting time next year.
Yeah. Oh, that was going out.
Here's the thing.
You just can't.
You know, when Julian came out, that was when Julian and Jordan Madison, the kid we call Beans, they came out after not having played for a couple years. And we had Robert Ryder, and we had, you know, those guys. And, you know, ultimately, milk it all spring, so I started Bonner and I started Julian in the spring. And Beans barely didn't get a single rep. I was focused on defense. I think Louder's a running back. He actually did okay against Orange Park. I haven't seen him do too much for that. I know they've all had like nagging injuries where they didn't play some. And but I'll tell you what.
Swing. How's he playing? Where does he
go? No, he ain't playing much. He ain't playing much at all.
So, I'm not going to pick that. I'm telling you, I'm going to be pissed if they come back for the Cowboys. I know it's coming.
Yeah.
And there's nothing I can do about it. There's nothing.
Well, I'll tell you what you can do. And this is just this is all your idea. Right of the world. And I know what I would do is I would bury them. Anytime they step out of line, there's no more coming to talk to me. There's no more going to talk to a guidance counselor.
No, that's for sure. And they may decide to stay there because, you know, you're talking about changing teachers, you know, expectations.
They I'm going to tell you, they are going to come back. At least some of them are coming back.
Oh, really?
Because at least one of them is coming back because they're going to do the whole game, it's the game-winning play. It's 3-0, the last play of the game, and they throw a screen to, Swain. He gets it, he's running, he's about to break it, and he just goes, and Stone is standing there. He just stands there like that. And then when he gets, you see Swain get close to him, he starts to run, he's like, oh, pitch it to me, give me the ball. And then Swain doesn't pitch the ball, he gets tackled, the game's over, and he throws it down the line.
Really?
Yeah. He stands there.
And does nothing.
Until it's a possibility I may get some ball. They're all doing it. We've seen most of their games in this, and I laugh at things like that. You know, I talked to Kyle Rice, and I know Kyle well. I knew him from years at Palaka. He was let a lot of things go type guy.
Thank you.
That's funny. So they got snacks and just go. Keep them up and come around and do
thank you.
One more day if I answer later.